What is going on there, family? This is my week. This should be the week that I should be taking over this bitch, because it is the Tennessee Titans and I live in Tennessee damn city. That's what I should be doing. I should be bashing this franchise that just prays to God. Please, let, come on, I want you to be our friend. Come on, East Tennessee, love us. I understand we just showed up in the 90s, but love us. Please love us. We don't care. Straight up, East Tennessee does not give a flying rat's ass about the Tennessee Titans. I mean, you come up here, I mean, there's been radio hosts around this area that does these polls. Who is your favorite franchise? Who's your favorite NFL team? And you think the local area, you think Tennessee Titans? You would be so damn wrong. I hear everything from Falcons to Redskins to Bengals, because Steve Weish, our former coach, is from Daniels. But you don't regularly hear Titans. And you know what? That's because East Tennessee doesn't give a shit about the Mid-State. Does not give two rats ass about the Mid-State. Only thing it pertains to is high school recruits, because Tennessee loves its mid-season. But anyway, we're talking about the Titans. We're talking about Bud Adams, Love Child. Now you can see why Bud Adams wanted to leave Houston to go to Nashville. But she ended up going to Memphis first, then went to Nashville. Which I gotta understand, because Memphis sucks balls too. But the Titans come in, which means 49ers get to play an old friend, an old buddy, Delanie Walker. They get to play Justin Hunter, which gives me some meaty juice, because I love Justin Hunter, and I don't want to see nothing bad happen to the guy. I also know how good the guy's going to be. Kendall Wright's a really good player. Chris Johnson should be a better running back than he is, but, you know, I don't know if he's too busy being rebellion or not or anything, but this game should be a scary game for me. Should be. The reason why I don't feel like it's going to be an absolute Titans win, because Mike Munchak is their coach. And he's on Mike Singletary level of bad coaching. You know, and don't get me wrong, I've heard people talk the praises of Mike Singletary. Mike Singletary was a motivator. Horrible X and O coach. And I've seen nothing from Mike Munchak that shows he knows anything about coaching at all. And Ryan Fitzpatrick as your quarterback does not make it any better. Walker was the quarterback. I'd even be a little bit more scared, because even with Mike Munchak, Walker, he's a quarterback. Nate Washington, Kendall Wright, and Justin Hunter, and Delanie Walker. Like I said, the offense, they got talent. This team is a talented team, but they just had coaching. They'd be a dangerous team. They could actually contend for sack. But they're not going to, because Bud Adams doesn't want to pay for a decent coach. It's the same guy that went, I want Vince Young. I know there's other quarterbacks that might be a better thing. I know he scored 8 on his Wunderlich, but I want that guy. Hey, look what he did in Texas. He's got to be good, right? Hell, son, you know, pick him. Let's sign him a whole bunch of money so he can blow at the freaking Cheesecake Factory. Seriously, how the hell do you spend $6,000 a month at the Cheesecake Factory? First of all, how in the hell do you do that? That shit's crazy. I can't believe that. That's crazy. You know, and the thing about it is that, you know, I should be okay with the Titans being and you know, living where they are and everything, but they try so hard to be the whole state of Tennessee's team. They try so hard. So hard. I mean, when they first got here, they pushed everything. I mean, having a game in the stadium and everything. You know, when they first came here, I saw a bunch of Titan stuff. When they first got here, it was Titan mania. And then all of a sudden, lo and behold, there stopped being car flags. There stopped being anything. The Titans radio went from a decent radio signal to now almost a non-existent one. Nobody cares about the Titans in Tennessee other than the people in around Nashville area, which is understandable because that's where they're local. Which is, it's kind of sad because, Jake Locker's a good player. You know, Justin Hunter's going to be a really good player. There's another trial for Tennessee for the Titans to try to be relevant in East Tennessee. Grab some balls. You know, Chris Johnson should be a good player. I mean, if Chris Johnson was in some other organization, I think he'd be a lot better off. It's hard to hate these guys. It's just like you're picking on a little kid. With a franchise that hasn't been relevant since Steve McNair was their quarterback.
And if you come to understand, it'll be okay.
Mason was their main wide receiver. When Frank Wycheck was a player, not a color card. You know, everyone remembers when the Music City Miracle where they did a quasi lateral. That's still debatable to this day. Beautiful, but that's the greatest playoff victory is a freaking last second. I have to beat Doug Flutie with a freaking lateral pass across the field to win the game. You know, you're just not a relevant matchup. I mean, you're on. It's hard to say you're a Jetson. I mean, you and Jacksonville are on. A level of irrelevance that is just sad. It's sad to watch bad football. And it sucks for me because I have to watch these guys on television. That's all I see is Titans here, Titans there. You know? Now granted, I watch Red Zone because I'm not watching Titans. But this team, 49ers should walk in there, pound the rock, and they should get a victory. Now, I'm not expecting a huge blowout. However, I see it being close for about 3 quarters in the fourth quarter. The 49ers should pull away. They say, we're done with you. We do some 90-yard drive or pound the rock, and we go home. That's all we actually have to do. We'll play the job. So, Titans, you are the roadblock to going to London and enjoying 2 weeks of rest. So, don't take this ass personally. Just take it like this. Anyway, Jalen, sign out. Peace.